So here I have a superconductor. It's encased in an insulating material. The insulating material serves two purposes. One, it keeps the outside at a much higher temperature than the inside, since we have to cool the material very cold to liquid nitrogen temperatures. The second is it creates a bath around these superconductors so it can stay cool longer. We can perform some of the experiments and see some of the phenomena that I'm going to show you. But I first wanted to show you when this is at room temperature, above its critical temperature. So if I place it on the magnetic field, there's no particular strong attraction to the magnets themselves. If I place it on the field and turn it sideways, it'll essentially fall right off. And the same is true for the circular magnet. If I place it on the circular magnet, it just slides right off. We'll see that behavior is different when we cool this below the critical temperature. So now we're going to look at the interaction of the superconductor. Once it's cooled below its critical temperature, where it can set up currents without resistance. In this styrofoam box, I have some liquid nitrogen, which is sufficiently cold to cool the superconductor below its critical temperature. I'm also going to use a glove to help protect my hand. Even though it's insulated, it still gets a little bit cold. So when I drop this into liquid nitrogen, some bubbling will occur due to the fact that the liquid nitrogen is giving up energy to the superconductor and is bubbling off as a gas. Once this reaches liquid nitrogen temperatures, the bubbling will become minimized, and I'll take it out using some non-magnetic chopsticks. So once it's cooled to liquid nitrogen temperatures, I know it's below its critical temperature. I can take it out with something non-magnetic, in this case chopsticks. I can place it on the magnetic grid, and you can see it's suspended, even though we know the square magnets are alternating poles. And if I turn it sideways, it stays locked in its relative position. If I turn it upside down, it stays suspended. So from a classic point of view, what is the free body diagram for the superconductor being suspended, levitating above, suspended on the side, or suspended from above? There are no contact forces here. This is solely magnetic fields and gravitation. Now, if I move it over to the circular side, because the magnetic field doesn't change as it rotates, I can freely rotate the superconductor even though it remains levitating above it.